What's up, VC? I'm back to do another video. We're gonna call this one Arbutus Record Show Finds Part 3, December, the last show of the year. This is my third time going, and usually I do pretty well. It's a good show. A lot of the dealers there have a lot of stuff, a lot of like a variety of stuff. So if you dig, you can find what you're looking for. Usually I knock off a lot of my want list pieces there, and pretty good prices, you know. So let's get into this. In the background, we are playing, which was one of my best scores of the day. Let me take the sleeve off. This is Elvin Jones, Dear John C. It's the original Impulse. Sure, the gatefold. Won't open it too much, still crackling, but there's my man Elvin smoking. Yeah, and this is just phenomenal. I got this from the same guy. He was there again that I got the Yucatan in from, and the Mr. Billy Higgins. And once again, this was marked 25, and he gave it to me for 20, which is a really good price. This thing is in, the cover's in like what I'd call VG Plus probably, and the record's just near mint. It's just awesome. So yeah, I was really, really happy to get that. As you can hear, Elvin just wailing in the background. The next piece I picked up was a copy of Anthony Braxton. This is Five Pieces, 1975. I paid 12 for this. This is really phenomenal. On the first side, it's he does his like usual, you know, his music math, how he does right there. But on the first side, there's a song called You Stepped Out of a Dream, which is actually my least favorite song on the piece. It's really good, but it's just, I don't know, it's just not my favorite song. I really like side two. It's really good. It's good. And there's the gatefold. And it's on the Arista label. Which is cool, the 70s Arista, the blue Arista label. That's really cool. Yeah, I paid 12 for that. It's in near mint shape, so really happy with that. That was definitely my want list. It's one of the last ones I need for my John McLaughlin collection. This is Devotion on Douglas. Yeah, and this is a heck of a piece. Here's the lineup. You got John McLaughlin on guitar, Buddy Miles on drums, Billy Rich on bass, and of course my man Larry Young on organ, which is awesome. And here's a shot of the Douglas label. It's actually a pretty cool label. Reminds me of the color scheme in Herbie Hancock's Manchild record. Not the Douglas label. Sounds really cool, score. I got that for $5 from a guy who was just blowing LPs out, just trying to get rid of them. I think, you know, he had the same stuff for a while. And, he was just making deals, so I picked up a couple from him. Next thing I scored was Grand Funk Railroad, On Time. And this is their first record. And I had been looking for this for a while. This was in a dude's dollar bin, and it's really not in that bad of shape. It's not a dollar record. It's on the late 60s, early 70s Capitol label. Yeah, and this is just really good. This is just straight ahead, like, blues rock, a little funk in there. Heavy, you know, hard rock. This is good stuff. Yeah, so Grand Funk's first. It's called On Time. It's a good record. If you see this, pick it up. This next one was not a grail, but definitely one I had been searching for. I think I saw Memphis Vinyl Jim show this. A shout out to Memphis Vinyl Jim. And shout out to Andrews. I just watched your newest video, man. You were showing some awesome stuff. That Black Sabbath box set looks awesome, man. But anyways, this is the Alan Bound. And this is on the Music Factory label. That's really cool. Yeah, I got this for, I think, $5. And this is in, the cover is like VG, VG Plus. Got a little weird to it, like a little punch. But the record is in like VG Plus near mint shape. So I was really, really happy to get that. This next one I got is Joe Henderson. State of the Tenor, Volume 1, Live at the Village Vanguard. And this is just phenomenal. This has Ron Carter on bass and Al Foster on drums. If you want to hear somebody blowing and just like a great exercise in like tenor supremacy and like not supremacy but like technicality and just vocabulary, you need to pick up this one on Blue Note, by the way, and then Volume 2, which the guy had as well. And I got these for $10 a piece, which is a really good price because they're not hard to come by, but they're not easy actually. They're kind of difficult to locate at times. So they were marked 20 and he had 50% off, so I got them each for 10. I was only going to pick up Volume 1, but I knew if I didn't pick up Volume 2, I would regret it. I like Joe Henderson's playing. I really like Ron Carter's playing. And Al Foster's a great drummer. And these are just great pieces. It's just a live blowing session almost. The next one I picked up is, I didn't have a copy. This is Free, Fire and Water. This has Fire and Water, which is a good song, but the song everyone knows is All Right Now, the last song on the B-side. It was really good. Free was an interesting band. Free was Paul Kossoff on guitar, who later died, I believe, on an airplane. He had a heart attack. Andy Frazier on bass, who was 15 at the time. And then they had Simon Kirk on drums and Paul Rogers on vocals. And Simon Kirk and Paul Rogers left to form, which was, in my opinion, I'm not a very good big fan of, but Bad Company. So yeah, this album is phenomenal. This is a good album. If you see this for cheap, pick this up. I think this is like an 80s repress. But the guy who sold to me was funny. He's actually he's a vendor, and he travels all up and down the East Coast. But he was actually, you know, he's got long gray hair and a long beard, and he was actually an extra in the new movie Lincoln with Daniel Day-Lewis, which is phenomenal, by the way. Not that it has anything to do with vinyl, but that's a great movie. If you're thinking about seeing it, go see it. But yeah, so he was a cool dude. Talked to him for a while. This next one I got, shout out to Seco Funk. Hit me to this dude. This is Dollar Brand. And this is called Memories on the, this is a reissue on the West 54 label. Oh, cool label. This is a solo piano record. And this is just beautiful. I really enjoy Dollar Brand's playing. I think that a lot of you guys that like jazz, he's a jazz pianist. And if you like solo piano work, and you're a fan of the piano, I think you should get hit to Dollar Brand. I think you should check out some Dollar Brand records. This was $5. This is 50% off, so this is $5. Great score. Not really easy to come by Dollar Brand. This next one I also paid $5 for. This is Parliament, the Clones of Dr. Funkenstein. And I mean, what can I say about Parliament? I mean, you got Bootsy on the horns, Fred Weasley, and my man Maceo Parker, who's a funky beast. Jerome Bailey on drums, Bigfoot, who actually taught, I don't know if you already know Dennis Chambers, who taught him a lot of how to have, he has a really fast bass drum foot, really flies, and he credits Bigfoot Bailey for teaching him how to really get down on that. Of course, my man George Clinton and Fuzzy Haskins, this just rocks. And it was actually a guy there selling his friend's records, and you know, I had that and the Allen Bound for like, I think, $18. And I was like, ooh, and he was like, you know what, let me make this easy for you. $10. Really cool guy. I've talked to him before. He recognized me from here, YouTube. But yeah, he's like, you know what? $5 a piece. And I can't argue with that. That's a great price. Great records. Good guy. All around good deal. The next one I picked up is a promo copy of Miles Davis Decoy. This is how it actually, you can see that. And this is on the 80s Columbia label with the solid numbers. This is not bad. This is definitely not one of Miles' best, but I'm a Miles Davis completionist, and I had this. This has been on my radar for quite some time, and you know, for $5, I couldn't pass this up. This is good. I mean, there's really no bad Miles. This is just kind of gets into that kind of a like drum program a little bit too electronic, if you ask me. But this is good. If you see this for like, well, I paid $5 for this, so if you see this for like $5, $7, $8, pick it up. It's definitely worth it, especially if you're into Miles Davis. It's just worth it. And the last score I found, which has been eluding me for a while, is Miles Davis at the Fillmore. And this is on Columbia. I won't show the labels, you know, the 70s Columbia label. This one is definitely during his 70s electric period. Like, came out right in the kind of start of it. Right kind of like towards the start to the middle of it. And this is just a phenomenal record, and I paid 10 for this, which I thought was a really good price for a double record. Both the records are near mint. A little bit of ring wear on this. This is just phenomenal. I mean, I've got like 23, 24 Miles Davis records now. I've almost got everything he's done from like 66 to 78. I've got almost everything he's released officially on vinyl. So yeah, he's definitely like a muse of mine, and definitely just a huge inspiration when I want to create music. It's kind of like, what would Miles do, maybe, almost sometimes. Even though I'm a drummer, I can take from his vocabulary and the space that he left between notes, which was phenomenal, especially in his later playing, in his electronic period, or his electric period. So yeah, that was my stack right there. Some really good finds, as usual. I was really happy with what I got, and for the price, all this was like $80, so you really can't beat that. A lot of good records in there. Also, for you people that live in the DMV area, you know, the DC, Maryland, and Virginia, the next DC Record Fair was just announced this morning. It's going to be on January 27th, which I believe is like 2.5 weeks. It's a Sunday, I think, at Penn Social in Northwest DC. So definitely go check that out. Just search DC Record Fair on Google and check that out, man. Those guys, you'll see a lot of vendors that you wouldn't normally see. If you go to the Arbutus show, check out the DC show. There's a lot of vendors there that don't go to the Arbutus show and that come from a little farther away, like up higher and more from out west. And you'll find a nice selection there. So I hope to see you guys there. I'm definitely going to be over there. I'm not going to buy any more vinyl until then. I'm going to be spending time listening to what I got. Because Anders, and also shout out to Glasswork at Aftermath. I don't think he watched my videos, but Mark. They were talking about how they need to slow down buying records and listen to more what they have. And I'm definitely a victim of that. Like, I'll listen to like 5 records, but then I'll buy another 10. And it's just like, you know, I want to spend time on listen to the music that I have. So I'm going to try not to buy any records until the DC Record Fair at the end of this month. And I'll post the flyer on the Facebook page. But yeah, so that does it for me for this video. Like I said, I hope everyone's doing well. Hope all y'all, had a good New Year, and the New Year's starting off right for you. Be well, and I will catch you on the next video.